Man, what it do, YouTube? Your boy back again. That video I made, I had this joint on the phones. I took them off, man. Couple months ago, I had bent the ring and shit, so I took them off. You know what I'm saying? I just really been riding back factory, my get around car. But this one I'm on, man. If y'all look in the last video, my first video, I had this joint sitting in the driveway. I told y'all this one was coming. We got them big sixes on it, man. Everything new, man. You know what I'm saying? Truck shocks, Expedition springs, down to the rotor, down to the merger brakes, man. We're going to do it right, man. Paint them shocks red, match the color. We're going to go back red. Oh, she got potential. She been hit the LED lights. Even got the motherfucking rear end matching. You know what I'm talking about? But she out the ground. But, man, I've been working on this front end, man. I'm making this video for everybody. I really, you know, was coming in and trying to get advice. Because I need, you know, I was running into some problems dealing with my front end, man, trying to get the strut line back up with the bottom hole. You know what I'm saying? Because I got the lift cup. You can see the lift cup on it. Them are foes over there. I had got all them joints refurbished, repainted. They're going to go in the burgundy car when I get through with this one. Everything. I got so many bosses and parts, dog. All my shit. Everything finna be new when I put these rim back on for both of them. Y'all stay tuned. But, man, I'm making this video, man, to show everybody what I was running into. So, for people that was looking at me, like, you know, I would come in and trying to get questions from people that do this type of, that did this type of work, man, did these lifts. I'm going to show y'all what my problem was. Now, fucking with Rock Auto, man. These motherfuckers, man. Now look. 2003 Crown Vic. I had my Rose struts, right? Brand new. I'm going to show you what my problem was for everybody I was asking. Like, damn, I got the cup on, but I can't get it lined up. I'm going to show y'all exactly what my problem is. And I just figured this shit out after days and losing weight, sweating and shit out here, man, stress and shit, man. This shit done defeated me so many nights, man, so many days, man. But I knew something was up, man. All right, so look at this, right? You see the bottom strut? How flat it is? All right, these the Moreau joint. I ain't fucking with them. These the FCS joints. I did this job probably about 2-3 years ago, probably longer than it. When I first got this joint, I changed out the upper control arms and the struts so I can ride a little better. Because this joint used to be a Lieutenant Fire Marshal car. As you can see, that's why it got the fire engine red. In the city, I bought it from the city auction. So the Lieutenant used to ride this motherfucker. So he sold. And I got this motherfucker head like, I think head about like 115. Some shit like that. But it was a good car, but, you know, city car, man, especially in Memphis, man, they ride the motherfucker. But it was a better one. It ain't one of the old police car. But this what I was going through, dog. The FCS joints, any joints that really supposed to fit, you see this lip? You know what I'm talking about? That's how I supposed to look at the bottom. This is why I couldn't get the Moreau joint on, because the lip on the Moreau joint flat. You know what I'm talking about? And it was hitting against the lower control arm. It wasn't sitting flush in the motherfucker. That's why I could never get the bottom bolt lined up. Excuse the myth. But it show a nigga really be in here getting his own work, man. We don't pay for shit, man. I do my own work. You know what I'm talking about? I'm gonna put these hoes side by side. So for anybody, man, that's looking to do this build, man. Man, I'm going through every emotion, man. Putting my shit together, man. You know what I'm saying? Now look. See how that's flat? You see that lip? This the back of the strut. This what goes into the lower control arm, how it's able to fit flush into the lower control arm so you can bolt it up to the bottom of it. You know what I'm talking about? This motherfucker ain't got no lip. And that's why I could never get the motherfucker lined back up. And I've been coming on everybody's shit that done did this work who got lips on their shit. And everybody was telling me, damn, bro, it shouldn't be that hard. I'ma pull this motherfucker back out. But let me cut the flash on, man. So I can show y'all, man. I can't cut the flash on. Yes, I got the flat light right here, man. Harbor Freight King, man. Any grown man, nigga, Harbor Freight is like a goddamn Victoria's Secret. Now, you see how this shit is? This is why I couldn't get it in there. Because the motherfucker ain't got that lip. So it's hitting against control arm. I wish I could take this motherfucker out and show you where it was hitting it. But that's the issue. The other one got the lip, so it fit into that groove. This motherfucker don't. That was my problem. Shout out to my boy Cut It. Cut It Customs out there in Bama, man. I hit him up. He was way better than a lot of people, no offense, but that man gave me his number. That man hit me up on the duo, walked me through it. He tried to help me out on video call, man. Real cool dude, man. Real deal, man. Like, that's who you want to Man, when folks be hitting you up with real deal questions, man, that's how you pull the, you know what I'm saying, reply and have some feedback, bro. Like, you know what I'm saying, bro? If you do the work, man, ain't nothing wrong to get somebody some help or some advice. I got this sway bar down. I fucked around and unbolting it so I can have extra clearance. And, man, one thing about these straight bar bolts and studs, them motherfuckers really is, like, permanent. Once you unhook them, you know, you probably can get it back in, but one of them, I'm gonna show you, one of them fucked around and came out with it. I had to order new studs, so them motherfuckers on the way. But I'm gonna get all this shit, man. When I tell you, everything finna be new. Detroit Alces, man, I got all type of shit. Front and back finna be slotted, man. You know what I'm talking about? AC Delco, control on. Everything finna be new in this motherfucker. This motherfucker gonna ride like a Cadillac when I'm doing that bar right there. My sway bar link. We doing it all, baby. We gonna do it complete. Ain't no half ass. You know what I'm saying? Everything on this motherfucker new, man. Getting that motherfucker together. I did my own trim work. Trim look good. But yeah, man. For future reference, folks, with this sway. If anybody run into this sway bar issue, deal with my issue. Took the motherfucker out, and the motherfucking thing came out with it. Can't get the nut off. See? Been hitting that motherfucking impact. I don't even, all that heating up shit. I'm like, fuck that. I'm gonna cut it off. And I just ordered all new studs so I can get it back in there. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if y'all can see. I can't even see what I'm looking at. But yeah. But yeah, man. She coming. She is coming. Just, but this is what I say, man. Nigga going through air motion, man. To get your shit, get my shit right. You know what I'm saying? I'm proud to put in the work. I ain't paying nobody for shit because at the end of the day, the shit ain't hard as long as you got the right tools, man. Like I say, hard before he came, man. And shout out to my boy Cut It. Cause I was fucking with it. I said, man, I need some bigger screwdriver. I went and got man, pry bars and my own type of shit, man. Got me another anchor grinder. Them hoes so cheap, I just grabbed one. But man, yeah, man, this for everybody that's building on these Crown Vicks, that's looking to boat up. Make sure you get the right straight if you have any problem lining back up. The shit ain't hard. Like I say, when I call Rock Auto motherfucking ass in the morning, I'ma send this one and the other one back. And this my third one. I got one on. They sent, then line up. And I'ma show y'all another thing. This a motherfucking problem. Cause this, I couldn't even use this no way. Now everybody know when you're doing stretch, this little notch right here, right? It pulled a line up. You see where it lined up? I couldn't use the motherfucker no way. And this brand fucking new. I couldn't use it. See, the bottom part supposed to be turned like this with the knots. The knots are all the way over here. So I won't be able to use this motherfucker no way. So yeah, man, anybody that's fucking around, man, you down in these, stay away from these Monroes, man. What the part number on these regular motherfuckers, man? TS271346. Don't even fuck with them. I'm gonna go right back to these, man. These on the cheap. But they got the job done. They the FCS stretch. If anybody was looking at them, probably thinking about them. They got the job done. Like I said, I put these motherfuckers on years back. You could tell it's kind of, it was going out. But still, man, at this point, man, I just want to, if it's going to be new, anyway it go, everything will be new up on the motherfucker. Anyway, it's still going to ride good. But yeah, man. I got this motherfucker when it was like 115. What I got, 172 on it now. And I'm talking, I bought this motherfucker probably like 2014, 2015. I had this motherfucker 6 years. But old baby, that's still old dependable. You know what I'm saying? Them folks gonna go back on her. She going to the paint job. She going to the paint shop. I'm going back burgering. She gonna get a nice fresh red coat on her. Had a little small little fender bender. Man, you can see, man, oily fingerprints, man. Put my own work in. You know what I'm talking about? Corona boxes coming in hand. Hold them calipers up. But yeah, man. Just a small little video, YouTube. Let you know what I'm going through. And appreciate